Hi, this lesson is about numbers from 100. Hola, esta lección es sobre los números desde el 100. Hi, welcome to Spanish for London again. My name is Laura and today we will continue studying numbers. Remember that numbers are irregular, so study them carefully. Don't think that numbers are easy. They are easy. They are not difficult, but study them carefully. Remember also that you have the first part of this lesson, which is numbers from 0 to 100. This will be the last lesson about numbers. And also you have another lesson, which is ordinal numbers, to know how to say the first, the second, the third, etc. And you have also another lesson, which is what time is it, to know how to say precisely the hour. Okay, let's see the numbers from 100. I wrote here numbers from 100 to 1000. First, focus on this. Let's see the names. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600, 700, 800, 900, 1000. Okay, I wrote the regular ones in red and the irregular ones in black. Let's see first the regular ones. 100, 100. We never say un 100. In Spanish, when you want to say 100, don't say un cien, it's only cien. Same happens with 1000. We don't say 1000, un mil. We say only mil. Okay, so cien, 100, mil, 1000. Then, of course, if you want to say 2000, you say dos mil, etc. Okay, now. When we say 100, we say 100, but when we want to say 101, 102, and so on, we don't say 100, but ciento. So 101 es 101, 102, 102, and so on until 199, 199. Then, you want to say 200, you say only, you put dos, which is two, and then plus cientos. Remember the S at the end because it's a plural form. It's two times 100, so it's not doscientos, but doscientos. And the same, tres plus cientos, 300, cuatro plus cientos, 400, 600, 800. Now let's see the irregular forms. We have three forms, 500, 700, and 900, which are irregular. Let's see the first one, 500, which is really irregular. To remember this, think in 5, 5, 15, 15, 50, 50, and 500, 500. The numbers of 5 are really regular. So if you are struggling with these numbers, try to apply this mnemonic rule. C, Q, C, Q. That's all. So, C, Q, C, Q. Do you remember the names of the letters in Spanish? C is C, Q is Q. Remember that you have a lesson about pronunciation and the alphabet, so go to that lesson. So, 5, 15, 50, 500, CQ, CQ. So, when you are struggling with these numbers, apply this rule. And then, 700 y 900 are slightly irregular. They only change one letter. Do you see? 7, 7. But 70 and 700, 70, 700. And then 9, 9, but 90 and 900, 90, 900. Now, if you have studied your irregular present tense part 1, You probably remember that we have some verbs changing e por ie or changing o por ue. So this is exactly the same and for the same reason. So remember, as in the verb poder, to be able to, when I say poder, I have o, but I can es yo puedo. So I change the o por ue exactly for the same reason. The o in 90, 900 changes for ue in 9. It's for the position of the accent. Nothing to do with verbs. It's a phonetical change. Same happens with 7, 70, 700. If you remember verbs like querer, to want, with the e, if I want to say I want, yo quiero, changing for ie, okay? In the same way, siete with ie, but 70, 700 with the e, for the same reason, for the position of the accent, okay? So now you know your numbers from 100 to 1000. Again, 100, but remember 101, 102, etc. 200, 300, 400, 500, the CQ-CQ rule. 600, 700, not 700, but 700. 800, 900, not 900, but 900, 1000. Then, of course, if you want to say 2000, say 2000, 3000, 3000, 10,000, 10,000, and so on. And then for 20,000, 20,000, do you see? 1,000,000 is 1,000,000, and then 2,000,000, 2,000,000. So we have the plural form for million. 1,000,000, singular, but 2,000,000, plural. And remember also, when you form the plural of a word ending with N and with the accent before the N, drop the accent when forming the plural. You have this rule explained in the class about how to form the plural. Then I will give you definitely more information about this in the class about accentuation rules. So you have all the classes in the list of topics in our course. Okay, now the blue part. Only some rules, some additional rules to remember when using your numbers. In Spanish, we only put the E, which is end, from 31 to 99. Del 31 al 99, we say 30 y 1. So 31, 30 y 2, 32, and so on until 99, 90 y 9. So remember, you have to put the E, which is Y, from 31 to 99, and that's all. Don't put the E in any other position when using numbers. So, for example, imagine that you want to say, I will write it here because I don't have more room here. If you want to say, for example, don't know, 230. Okay, 200, 200, and then 30, well, this is in the first lesson, 30. Do you see? I do not say 200 y 30. You don't put E here. You only put E from 31 to 99. So if the number is, for example, 234, here I say 200, and now I have 34, which is comprised here, so I say 34, okay? So remember this, when you are not sure about the E, remember 31 to 99, okay, I put the E. In other cases, I don't, that's all, okay? This was our first rule. Second, some numbers, typically the numbers from 1, los números del 1, have feminine and masculine. So if I say a friend and he's a man, I say un amigo. But if I say a friend and she's a woman, I say una amiga. So I have a friend will be tengo un amigo. I have a female friend will be tengo una amiga. And same happens with all the numbers from 1, 21, 31, 41. So suppose that I have 21 male friends. Tengo 21 amigos. I have 21 female friends. Tengo 21 amigas. And same happens with the numbers from 100. They have feminine and masculine. So I have 200 male friends. Tengo 200 amigos. I'm exaggerating a little. Or I have 200 female friends. Tengo 200 amigas. Okay? So remember, numbers from 1, un, una, 21, 21, 31, 31, etc. And numbers from 100, 200, 200, 300, 300, etc. take feminine and masculine forms. Okay. Another thing, when we are talking about dates in English, we say the numbers in pairs. So, Hastings Battle. How good are you in history? Hastings Battle, 1066. End of Second World War, 1945. So we say 1066 or 1945 for dates. Don't do that in Spanish. You are not allowed to do that in Spanish. You have to say the whole number. So if I'm talking about Hastings Battle, I must say, la batalla de Hastings fue, was, in, and now 1066. So, 1000, 1066. Don't forget your I, because 66 is here, in this group. So, we don't say 1066, we say 1066. And the end of the Second World War, el final de la Segunda Guerra Mundial, fue en, and I don't say 1945, 1945. I say 1945. So, 1,000, 1,900, 945. El final de la Segunda Guerra Mundial fue en 1945. Okay, remember that. Say the whole number for dates. And last thing, in numbers, when you write numbers, in English we put comma here. We don't do that. Write dots or nothing, but not commas. We use commas only for fractions in math. Okay? That's the end of the lesson. Now you know your numbers. Remember to practice your numbers because they could be, as I told you before, they are irregular, so you have to master them, you have to use them properly. So practice, because then when you use them, you forget frequently when to put the I, or you forget that you have some feminine and masculine forms, or the irregular 5, 15, 50, 500, etc. So practice and practice. Remember, practice is all. La práctica es todo. That's the end of the lesson. See you next time. Este es el final de la clase. Nos vemos la próxima. Adiós.